Okay, everybody, welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. Today we are going to finally start looking at how to code an agent. All right, so let's create a new world. Let's go to creative, operator, and flat. Let's show coordinates as well for this one, why not? And click play. Now, a lot of the lessons within Minecraft Education Edition that have been created that are in your library pack or ones that have been created privately that you might access through the website are all about coding with agents, so getting agents to complete tasks. And that is, of course, what most computing teachers probably have looked at this software for. And to get started with that very, very basically, we need to go to the code builder. All right, so once we're in our world, we're going to press C on our keyboard, which is going to take us to the code builder. Now, you might have noticed as soon as I pressed that code builder, this chap appeared. This is my agent. All right, so even just by pressing C, our code builder has appeared. Now, I'm going to move away from my agent just to demonstrate something very shortly. So if I press C again and go to code builder, and I went to Microsoft Make Code, all right, just to get to this little thing here. And if I go, if I go back, and here, this is the editor that we can choose. All right, so Microsoft Make Code here. Let's click here. And there's a few good tutorials that teach us a little bit about coding. What they do is they limit the coding that you can get access to, just so that you're learning in quite a structured way, which I'd highly recommend for your students to go through and try some of these. They're good. But for today, we're going to create a new project, and we'll call it Agent. We're coding our agent today. And here you can see we've got a couple of blocks in here already. On start and on chat command are both here. Let's drag this one out and delete it there. And let's change this one to TP, which is going to be short for teleport. All right, now down the left here, we've got our different types of blocks that we can code with. So we're looking at coding the agent today, so it makes sense to click on this one. And we're going to agent teleport to player. Right, so let's click across here and go back to our Minecraft world. Now, as you can see, I moved away from our agent a little bit, and I have put the coordinates in the top left of this world. So we can see that I'm slightly removed from the starting point. So let's hit T to bring up the chat and commands box, and let's type in TP and hit enter. And as you can see, my agent's teleported back over to me here. Quite useful sometimes if you're not sure where your agent's gotten off to, if you're doing some coding and they've wandered off, to bring them back. So it's always useful to have that one there. C to go back to our coding now. And let's go ahead and bring in a few more of these on chat commands. And we'll right click and duplicate and create three of those in total. We'll have one for moving forward. Pop that there. We'll have one for turning left, and we'll have one for turning right. And the reason these are a different color is because they've got the same text in there, so we don't want multiple ones with the same text. So the one for turning left we'll call LT, and the one for turning right we'll have RT, and of course we'll change that to right. Now, this is a very basic way for students on a first lesson to understand how to interact with their agent. And of course, this is using the blocks. You could go across and you could look at the Python language of coding there, which we will be looking at a little bit further down the line. But for now, let's go back to Code Builder with the blocks and see how we can use this in our Minecraft world. So let's try a few of these. Right, so let's get our agent. Let's press T again, press FD. Let's try once more. He's not very responsive. Let's see what's wrong. That's because I've left it at jump, so FD. Silly me. Right, okay. Let's try that again. So T, FD, and off he goes. FD again. He's moving. T. Let's get him to do a right turn. RT. And then FD again. So very slowly we can start moving our agent around in the Minecraft world. Of course, there's a million more things we can do with the agents, but these are the kind of very basic things we need to do. Now, just before we finish up, you can, of course, stack up these commands. So if I go and chat command square, for example, what we can do is get the agent to move forward by 5 blocks. Then we can get the agent to turn left, and we can go ahead and repeat that four times, and then we should move around in a square. If I type square, there we go. So let's try that. There we go, back to where we started. So let's go back to our coding. So things like this are a pretty good way to teach your students how to stack these different blocks to get the agents to complete more complicated tasks. So the agent here, you can very slowly navigate around. But if you've got a very clear idea of what you want them to do, you can start stacking up these blocks to specific chat commands like square or build house or something like that. So we are going to be continuing to look at building upon this and doing slightly more complicated coding for our agent. But this is a really good start. So if you're doing a first lesson on coding with your students, I'd recommend something like this would be a very good start, okay? Do subscribe, like this video, because there'll be lots more coming along. But for now, thanks for tuning in.